Hello, everyone. I hope you all had a very peaceful and safe New Year celebration. And I've been thinking about what's different about this new year, 2021, from last year. And really many things are going to be the same for a while at least. But what is different is the sense of time. Last year we were scrambling, overwhelmed, in shock, and in some cases in paralysis. And while there will surely be more of that to come this new year, what's different is that last year we were in a state of limbo, not knowing when about a lot of things. And this year there is a bit more of a sense of time. There is more talk of when things will relax, when it will be safer to visit and travel and do some of our favorite things. Some of that will happen this year, I'm sure of it. And so while January is a great time for making aspirations and intentions, this year's unique. And so what I propose is that we focus on this time that we have now until things open up and relax a bit. What does this time allow us to do? So instead of focusing on what we can't do now, can we try focusing on what this time is actually good for? Because we know now that this time is limited, and so perhaps we can frame it differently and use it to our advantage in some way to do some of the things that were harder to do pre-pandemic. And so maybe this is a good time to read the books you've always wanted to read, or start a meditation practice, or learn a new language. And maybe you're doing some of this already, which is great. But if not, I get it. Last year was really hard and it still is, but we know a bit more about what's happening and about what's to come. And so in this light, for the month of January, I'm gonna share a daily practice of something simple and sweet that could be incorporated into our everyday. So check them out and let me know what you think. And then maybe by the end of January, you'll have a few more tools in your self-care toolbox to help make each day as lovely as possible. And that could stay with you for the long term. I've written a blog post as well that goes into more detail about this, so you can always check that out by following the links. And I'll try to post my little self-care morsel first thing in the morning. Okay, so stay tuned for that. And so maybe our first little self-care morsel could be just what I've been talking about, to take a moment to dream about what things you could fill this phase with, what things fit perfectly for the circumstances that we're in right now, so that when we do start to transition into a new phase later this year, we can look back at this time and feel a little bit more at peace for how we spent it. Okay, so there it is. Stay tuned, and as always, I'm wishing you very well. Take good care.